for joining me today. So for today's practice, we're just going to use our bodies, so we're not going to use any props, but if you do have a blanket or blocks or a strap and you want to bring that into your practice, feel free to do that. So we are going to begin in an easy seated position. So you can place one foot in front of the other, maybe kind of shift and adjust your weight to really feel the sit bones grounding down into the earth. As you lengthen up nice and tall through the spine, and then let's soften the shoulders back and down here. Maybe those palms find the tops of the knees. So let's just slightly tuck the chin to elongate the back of the neck, and then bring and draw that energy up through the crown of the head here. And then let's close the eyes. And let's just take a few deep breaths in and a few deep breaths out. Again, when you draw that inhale, try to bring it down into the pelvic floor here as it rises up through the belly, the chest, all the way up through the throat. Maybe you find a slight pause at the top of the breath to feel your body completely full of air. And then exhale, letting something go here. Again, as you inhale, fill the lungs completely full of air, finding that slight pause at the top. Then exhale, letting something go. But two more times as we inhale deeply, but finding that pause at the top, and then exhale completely. Good, one last full deep inhale, making it the biggest breath yet. Staying for that pause, and then exhale, softening. Letting go. Good, let's start to blink the eyes open here. And then let's take a nice deep inhale. Let's lift those arms up overhead. Good, reaching up to the sky here. Maybe you kind of shimmy side to lengthen each side body at a time. Good, and then let's take another deep inhale. And then let's come into a twist. So let's bring that right hand on that left knee. Left hand comes behind us as we inhale, lengthening up. Really hug that navel in to protect the spine here. And then exhale, coming into that twist. Good, using the breath as you inhale to lengthen up. Exhale to twist a little bit deeper. Good, full breath in here. And then let's come forward as we bring that left hand on top of that right knee. Taking another deep inhale, lengthening up. And then exhale, we're gonna bow forward, lowering that forehead and chest down. Good, keep rooting through the sit bones, keeping that connection with the earth. And then we'll start to bring the chest back up, and we're gonna find eagle arms. So we're gonna wrap the forearms, or you can bring those hands to the shoulders. Good, wherever you are, let's drop those elbows down, opening up through the shoulder blades as we soften the breath and the muscles within the face. Good, on your next inhale, let's lift those arms back overhead. Good, finding that length through the torso and arms. And then let's switch sides. So bringing that left hand on that right knee, right hand comes behind us. Again, inhaling as we lengthen up, drawing that navel in, and then exhaling, coming into that twist. Good, inhale, lifting the chest, keeping the spine long. Exhale, going a little bit deeper into the twist. Good, deep breath in here. And then coming forward, bringing that right hand on that left knee as as we lengthen up nice and tall once again, and then exhale, hinging at the hips, lowering the forehead and chest. Good, lifting the chest back up, finding eagle arms on the other side. Good, drawing those elbows down, lifting up through the heart, opening up the shoulder blades. Good, on your next inhale, let's lift those arms up one last time, finding some reach within the body. And then exhale, softening those arms down. Good, let's roll over onto our hands and knees, coming into tabletop position. So let's take a few moments here. Let's really open up the fingertips, creating some space between each one. As we ground down through the palms, as we stack the shoulders over the wrists, the hips over knees. We're just gonna do a few rounds of cat-cow next. So let's take a nice deep inhale here, neutral. And then on that exhale, we're gonna start to round up through the spine, hugging that navel in as we tuck the chin and tailbone. Good, on your in-breath, we're gonna drop the belly as we pull the shoulders away from the ears, flexing through the spine, maybe that gaze lifts. Good, exhale, finding cat once again as we round up through the spine. And then inhale, finding cow. Pulling that heart forward. Good, so just doing a few rounds at your own speed as you connect the movement with your breath here. Feel free to find other movement as you pivot in between the poles. So maybe you find movements within the neck or the hips. But just whatever feels right for your body here in this moment. Last few rounds. And then when you feel that movement's completed, let's come into child's pose just for a few breaths to get out of the wrists here. So lowering those sit bones down towards the heels, really lengthening those arms out as you sink the heart down, relaxing the forehead down onto your mat. Good, so softening the body and breath here. And then let's start to pull that heart forward as we restack those shoulders over wrists. Let's tuck those toes, let's lift those knees, and let's send those hips up and back into downward facing dog. So again, really rooting down through the palms here, creating space between the fingers to cover more ground. As you soften the head between the arms, rotating those shoulders away from the ears, and then really hug that navel in to send that tailbone up towards the ceiling, and then pressing those hamstrings back. Good, here in your down dog, feel free to find some playful movements, walking the dog. Good, maybe pivoting that weight side to side, coming onto the edges of the feet here. Maybe you deepen those knees, squat. Then maybe you lift an arm, playing and testing your balance. And lift in the other one. Good, and then let's take a nice deep breath in here. We're gonna find an audible exhale. So let's open up the mouth, letting something go. Good, let's repeat as we inhale deeply. Open up through the mouth. Good, one last time as we inhale through the nose. Open up the mouth, letting go. Good, let's start to look towards the top of our mat and let's start to tippy toe our feet up to meet our hands. Try to keep those hips high here. And then we'll lower those heels down. We're gonna really engage the core, because the more you engage the core, the closer the chest can go deeper in towards those legs. And then let's relax the neck by dropping the crown of the head down. And then trying to feel heavy here. So drop the weight of the shoulders and the arms down towards the earth as you feel that nice stretch along the entire back side of the body. Good, keep focusing on your breath here. And let's start to find some movement within the head. So let's shake the head, yes. Let's shake the head, no. And just letting go of any unwanted tension through the body, through the mind, through the breath. Good, let's take a deep breath in and let's draw those hands onto the tips of the fingers or the shins or the thighs. So we're gonna come into a halfway lift here and we really wanna think about lengthening the spine. So pull those hamstrings back while bringing that energy out through the crown of the head here. Shoulders draw away from the ears. Good, deep breath in. And then finding that forward fold, deep breath out. Good, let's do that two more times as we inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold, relaxing the head and neck. Good, one last time, inhale, lifting the heart, pulling those legs back, pulling the heart forward. Good, exhale, forward fold. Good, let's take a nice little slight bend within the knees and let's start to inhale to lift the body up as we draw those arms up overhead, palms touch, and then exhale, bringing those hands to heart center. Good, let's release those hands down and let's find Tadasana. So really rooting down through the soles of the feet, feeling that connection again with earth as we bring that weight back into the heels. Good, slight bend within the knees to let that energy flow in as we spiral those inner thighs in, locking the energy up towards the midline, and then softening those shoulders back and down as we open up the palms. So let's take a moment here and let's close the eyes. Feeling our bodies in this position, acknowledging our breath, and just knowing that you have everything you need right here inside of you. Start to open up the eyes here and let's find some flow within our practice. So let's inhale, arms up overhead. Maybe you bring that gaze up towards the sky here. And then exhale, let's softly bow forward, relaxing the head and neck down. Good, in breath as we lengthen halfway. Out breath as we find that forward fold. We're gonna place our hands down onto our mat and we're gonna step that right foot back. We're gonna lower that back knee and then we're gonna stack that left knee over that left ankle and then we're gonna inhale, lifting the body up as we draw those arms up overhead, palms face each other here. It's really lengthening through the side bodies as we soften the shoulders down. Good, strong foundation through the legs and feet. Taking that in breath and then lowering down on that out breath. Tucking those back toes, lifting that back knee, stepping back into plank pose here. And then let's start to come onto those toes as we pivot that weight forward, stacking the shoulders over wrists, lowering those hips. Let's inhale. And then let's exhale, let's lower all the way down. We're gonna release the tops of our feet as we hug those elbows in towards our side. Let's inhale up into cobra. Good, so you can make your cobra as small or as large as it feels comfortable for your lower spine. We're just making sure you're breathing deeply down into the belly. And then let's find some flow here in cobra. So let's lower the chest back down, grounding down through the hips all the way through the tops of the feet here. Let's inhale up as we start to bring that gaze past that right shoulder. Good, exhale, we lower back down. Inhale, we lift back up as we bring that gaze to the left shoulder. Exhale, lowering the chest down. Good, let's do that one last time as we inhale, making that cobra as big or as small as it feels comfortable for your spine, bringing that gaze to the right. Good, exhale, lowering the heart. Inhale, lifting the heart, bringing that gaze to the left. Good, exhale, lowering down here. This time, let's tuck our toes, keeping those hands underneath the shoulders. Let's lift back up into plank, and we'll bring those hips back into down dog. Let's take a breath here. And then with the strength of the core, let's bring the left knee up into the chest as we step that left foot forward. This time we're gonna lower that right knee down onto our mat and then we're gonna lift the chest up, arms come up overhead here. And maybe you start to soften your gaze, unlocking your jaw, rounding the breath. So let's take that deep in breath here and then we'll lower down on the out breath, tucking those back toes, lifting that back knee. Let's step that left foot to meet the right in plank. As we pivot that weight forward, coming onto those toes and then strong arms, strong core as we exhale to lower all the way down. Inhale to open up the heart. Exhale, pulling those hips back, down dog. Good, so just reconnecting with the breath if you've lost it. Feeling the strength within your body here as you soften the thoughts within the mind. Then let's start to look forward towards those hands. We're gonna really bend those knees here, sinking those sit bones down. And then let's find a nice little bunny hop up to meet those hands. Forward fold here. And then lifting the heart halfway as we take that in-breath. And then finding forward fold on the out-breath. Good, inhale, we rise up as we bring those arms up overhead, palms touch. And then exhale to heart center. Good, so let's move on from here. Let's inhale, arms up. Maybe you find a slight back bend here. And then exhale, leading with the heart to keep that spine long, forward fold. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, forward fold. We're gonna place those hands back down onto our mat. We're gonna bend those knees and we're gonna hop back into plank pose. As we inhale here, exhale, chaturanga. So coming down halfway, but releasing the tops of our feet. Let's inhale, up dog, thighs off the mat. Good, exhale, down dog. Good, let's inhale, left leg up. So we're coming into a three-legged dog here. Good, weight evenly pressing through both the hands. Then let's start to pivot that weight forward, but let's step that right foot forward. We're gonna lower that back knee down onto our mat. And then we're gonna keep that right hand planted as we lift that left arm up. Easy twist. Easy breath in, and then easy breath out as we lower that left hand down. We're gonna tuck those back toes, we're gonna lift that back knee, and then we're gonna come onto the tops of the fingers here. Good, pressing and elongating the spine as we pull that heart forward, sinking those hips down. Two more breaths. Good, we're gonna pivot that back heel down onto our mat as we open up into warrior two. So we wanna stack those shoulders over the hips here, making sure that right hip joint is in line with that right ankle joint, and really press down through that right pinky toe. As we elongate those arms out, let's take an in-breath, pulling through those fingertips, softening our gaze through that left middle finger. And then you want to keep that left knee stacked over that left ankle, trying to bring that front thigh parallel to your mat. Softening through the shoulders. Allowing the breath to ground you into the stillness of the pose. Last breath or two. And then let's come into star pose. So let's start to straighten that front leg. Let's pivot those left toes towards the long side of our mat here. And then we're gonna flip those palms up to face the sky. Good, maybe you close your eyes here as you ground down through the edges of the feet. And then let's start to bring those hands up overhead, palms touch. And then we're gonna bring those hands down into the heart center. We're gonna find side lunge next, or Skadgasana. So let's start to pivot our weight to the right as we lift those left toes off our mat here. And then options for the hands, so they can stay at heart center. You can straighten them out towards your sides. But just try to keep lifting through the heart to make the spine long. Good, keep breathing. Staying present within your practice here. Good, last final breath, staying for that exhale. Good, and then let's start to pivot that weight towards that left side as we frame that left foot with our hands. And then let's step back into plank pose. As we inhale, plank, exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, down dog. Let's switch sides. So let's inhale, right leg up. Good, exhale, we're stepping it forward. We're gonna keep that left hand grounded as we reach that right arm up, lowering that back knee. Easy twist. Good, let's take a deep breath in. And then a deep breath out as we lower that right hand down. This time we're going to tuck those back toes, lift that back knee, and we're going to come onto the tops of our fingers as we pull that heart forward, lengthening through the spine, sending those hips down, and keep that engagement within that left leg. Good, two more breaths here. And let's start to drop that back heel as we lift the torso up, warrior two. So again, we're gonna stack those joints, shoulders over hips, left hip bone in line with that left ankle bone. Then we're gonna reach those arms out. Deep breath in, deep breath out. Good, let's start to find star pose. We're gonna straighten that front leg. We're gonna pivot those toes towards the long side of our mat. And then again, we're gonna lift those palms up to face the sky here. Good, all four corners grounded down onto your mat here. And then let's reach those arms up overhead, palms touch. And let's bring them to heart center, finding side lunge or svadhasana on the other side. So pivoting that weight to the left as those right toes come off the mat. Good, playing with the balance and the strength of your body. You can keep those hands at heart center, or you can straighten them out to your sides. And then maybe one day that heel, that left heel meets the floor. Good, two more breaths. And we'll start to pivot that weight to that right side, framing that right foot with our hands. And then let's step that right foot to meet the left, plank pose. And then chaturanga into up dog. Coming back into down dog. Good, let's take a few breaths here. And let's start to deepen those knees. As we bring that gaze forward, let's just tiny little hop forward into a forward fold. And then inhaling, halfway lift. Exhaling, forward fold. We're gonna find chair pose this time. Uttanasana. So let's start to bend those knees. Good, let's start to lift the chest up as we bring those arms up overhead, palms face each other. Good, really engaging the core here, bringing that weight back into the heels. Let's take a few breaths here. Good, one last deep inhale. And then let's straighten the legs, finding forward fold on the exhale. Good, inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. Good, let's place those hands on our mat. As we bend those knees, let's hop back into plank pose. Inhaling plank, exhale to chaturanga. Inhale. Up dog as we open up the heart here. Exhale, down dog. Good, let's inhale, left leg up, three-legged dog. Exhale, we're stepping it forward. This time we're gonna keep that back knee lifted as we plant that right palm down, lifting that left arm up. So really find your foundation here through that left foot and the ball of that right foot. And then we're going to start to really engage the core here. And then we're going to start to lift the torso up. Left arm faces back, right arm faces forward. Keep pulling left hip forward, right hip back. And then let's start to bring those hands up overhead. And let's start to drop that back heel, finding warrior one. So tucking that tailbone here, stacking that left knee over that ankle. Hips face the front of your mat. Good, let's start to release those hands down. Let's interlace them and let's draw those knuckles down towards your mat to lift and open through the chest. Maybe you find a slight bend within the spine. But keep engaging that back leg. And then let's find humble warrior. So we're gonna start to hinge at the hips to lower the heart down. And then maybe those knuckles start to face the ceiling as you relax the head and neck. Good, two more breaths here. Feeling that strength within that front leg. And then let's softly release those hands down. Let's pivot onto those back toes as we step that left foot to meet the right and plank. Inhaling plank. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, up dog, thighs off the mat. Exhale, down dog. Good, let's switch sides as we inhale, right leg up. Three-legged dog here. Good, exhale, we're stepping it forward and we're keeping that back knee lifted. As we place that left hand down, we're gonna reach that right arm up. Easy twist. And then again, be mindful of your core here. Let's start to lift the chest up, bringing that right arm back, this time left arm forward. Good, softening through the shoulders, breathing into those fingertips. Good, let's start to bring those arms up overhead as we drop that back heel down, warrior two. So we're framing those hips towards the front of our mat here. As we tuck the tailbone down, nip the lower ribcage in, open up through the chest. let's start to release those hands down as we interlace them behind us, grounding those knuckles down, drawing the shoulders away from the ears. Maybe you find a slight back bend. Deep breath in. Deep breath out. Good, let's start to find humble warrior as we hinge at the hips, bowing forward, relaxing the head and neck down, bringing those knuckles up towards the sky. Good. Try to keep bending that front knee. Good. Squeeze those shoulder blades in. One last breath here. And then let's start to release those hands down. Good, let's bring the right foot to meet the left in plank. And then lowering down, inhaling up, exhaling back, downward facing dog. Then let's move on. So let's lift that left leg up, three-legged dog. And then exhale, stepping it forward. We're gonna keep that back knee lifted. I'm really trying to press that energy back towards that heel. And then let's lift the torso up, arms overhead. We can sink into the hips here. Let's start to bring those hands to heart center. We're gonna find warrior three next. So we're gonna start to pivot that weight onto that left leg. And we're gonna start to really bend that left knee to lift that right leg up. And then hinging at the hips, lowering that torso down parallel to the earth as we press that energy back into that back heel, flexing those right toes down. Good, strong foundation within that left leg here. Keep pulling that energy out through the crown of the head. One last breath. And then let's bend that left knee to step that right leg back down onto our mat. Good, we can release those arms. We're gonna start to straighten that left leg. We're gonna find goddess pose next. So we're gonna bring those heels in, toes pointed out. Let's bring those hands to heart center here. And then let's start to bend those knees to lower those sit bones. And we wanna try to bring those knees over those ankles. So a lot of times we pivot those knees forward. Let's draw them back. Good, keep lifting through the chest to keep that spine long. Good, focusing on your breathing here. Good, let's take two more breaths, maybe sinking those sit bones down a little bit deeper. Good, let's start to straighten those legs. We'll pivot those left toes towards the long side of our mat as we lower those hands. Inhale, plank. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, down dog. Good, let's switch sides. So inhale, right leg up. Exhale, we're stepping it forward. And inhale, we lift the torso up. Good, pressing that back heel up towards the sky, sinking into the hips, bringing that front knee over ankle. Good, hands come to heart center as we prepare for warrior three. So pivoting that weight forward, really deepen that front knee as we lift that left leg up, and then lowering the chest. Flexing those left toes down towards the mat, pressing that energy back into the heels. Nice long straight spine here. Keep breathing. As you find that drishti, or a focal point to gaze on, that will help you with your balance here. Good, two more breaths. And then let's start to deepen that front knee once again to step that back foot down. We're gonna start to straighten that right leg, pivoting those right toes towards the long side of our mat. We're gonna find a straddle forward fold. So let's bring those hands to our hips here. And we wanna make the edges of our feet parallel to the short side of our mat. And then again, leading with the heart, because we wanna keep that spine long here, hinging at the hips. We're gonna lower the torso down. Maybe those hands start to slide down those legs here. And then releasing the head and neck. Good, so feeling that nice stretch along the entire back side of the body as we relax and surrender through the spine. Good, following the rhythm of your breath here. Final breath. And then lifting the chest back up, pivoting those right toes towards the front of our mat as we lower those hands down. Let's step back into plank. Chaturanga. Up dog. Down dog. Good, let's inhale, left leg up, three-legged dog. We're gonna come into pigeon pose next. So we're gonna pivot that weight forward and we're gonna lower that left leg up towards those hands as we lower that back knee down onto our mat. So let's find the foundation first. We wanna bring that left hip back, right hip forward. Good, you wanna try to keep that front shin parallel to the top of your mat. And then you can always just stay here on the palms, or if you want to walk those hands out, coming onto the forearms, let's bow the head down, and let's close the eyes here. We really want to breathe into that left hip bone, that left hip joint. Last breath or two here. And then if you're on your forearms, let's start to walk those hands back in towards the body. As we tuck those back toes, lift that back knee, let's step back into down dog. Let's switch sides for pigeon. So let's inhale, right leg up. Exhale, let's bring it forward and lowering that back leg down. Good, framing and squaring those hips here towards the top of your mat. And then when you're ready, walking those hands out, coming to the edge of the pose for you here. And maybe stopping the eyes closed. And breathing into that right hip joint. The last couple breaths. Then nice and gently taking your time, let's walk those hands in. And this time we're just going to pivot our weight to that right side to bring that left leg forward. We're gonna keep that right knee bent, bringing that right foot inside that left thigh here. And then we're gonna square those hips towards that left leg. Let's inhale, arms up overhead. And then exhale, hinging at the hips, lowering the chest down. Good, bringing those hands to the earth. You can bring them to your shin, ankle, or your foot. Good, trying to bring that forehead down towards that left leg as you keep pulling the heart forward to keep that spine straight. So let's inhale, arms up overhead here. We're gonna release that right arm down, keeping that left arm by that left ear. Let's inhale, lifting the hips up as we come onto that right knee and left foot. Then your next exhale, let's lower those hips down. Good, let's switch sides. So straightening that right leg, bending through the left, squaring those hips towards that right leg. And with that inhale, lifting those arms up overhead. And with that exhale, folding forward, lowering the chest and forehead down. Enjoying the pose for one last final breath here. Allow yourself to stay for that exhale. And then we're gonna lift the heart back up as we bring those arms up overhead. Let's lower that left arm down, keeping that right arm up. And then let's inhale, lifting those hips high, coming onto that left knee and right foot. And maybe you find chin mudra here, bringing the pointer finger and thumb together. Good, let's take an inhale, pulling those the hips a little bit further. Good, and then exhale, lowering those hips down. Good, let's start to lower down onto our back. Good, feel free to just automatically hug those knees into the chest. Good, maybe find some rock side to side, or some circles within the hips. Good, from here, let's find happy baby pose. So keeping that tailbone down onto our mat here, let's bring those knees out to our sides. And then you can bring those hands anywhere along the legs, ankles, inside of the feet, the big toes. And then let's start to deepen those knees down towards the earth here as we start to find some playful movements for the hips. Slowly release those hands. Let's draw those knees back into the chest as we wrap those arms around the legs, giving ourselves a nice big hug here. And then let's find bridge pose next. So let's bring those soles of those feet down onto our mats. Good, arms down by our sides with the palms facing down. Let's start to walk those heels in. Good, keeping the chin and neck still here. Let's inhale, hips up. Good, so we can ground down through the palms here. As we really squeeze those inner thighs in to stack those knees over ankle. Good, you can stay just where you are here. Or if you'd like, let's start to walk those shoulder blades in, interlacing those hands underneath of you, just giving us a little bit of a deeper bend through the spine. Good, looking up towards our bellies. Finding nice, full, rounded breaths here. So on your inhale, allow that belly to balloon open. And on that exhale, allow that belly to deflate. It's when we're in these deep back bends here, it's really good for the heart chakra. So if you want to envision green light coming in and around the heart, feel free. Good, let's take one last final breath here. And then we can release those hands to lower those hips down. Let's find that counter pose for the spine as we draw those knees in. Good, let's open up those arms out to a T here, and let's find a twist. So we're gonna just drop those knees to the right. Good, we can remain looking up towards the sky, or we can drop that left ear down towards our mat, getting an upper spinal twist. And let's start to bring those knees back into the chest, switching sides, dropping them to the left, looking up or dropping that right ear down. Slowly bringing those knees back into our chest. Let's wrap those arms over the legs once again, giving ourselves a nice big full hug. Maybe the forehead comes up to kiss those knees. And then on that exhale, let's find Shavasana. So let's open up those legs wide here, bringing those arms down by our sides. Or you can bring one hand on the heart, one hand on the belly. And just shifting and adjusting your weight so you're comfortable here as we keep those eyes closed. And then just like we did at the beginning of our practice, let's take a deep breath in. And a deep breath out, softening into the pose here as we feel Mother Earth supporting and nourishing us all. Softening through the body. Surrendering. First, just noticing the sounds around you. The sounds in the distance. The sound of my voice. And let's bring that attention in towards the smells within the room. The tastes within our mouths. The colors behind the closed eyelids. And lastly, feeling our body on this earth. Let's start to find some movement within the body here, maybe wiggling those fingers and toes, circling the wrists and ankles. And then let's draw those arms up overhead, getting a nice full body stretch here. And maybe you find that audible exhale. Good, one at a time. Let's hug those knees back into the chest one last time, wrapping those arms around the legs. And then let's start to rock side to side. And let's land on one side. Let's take a full breath here, feeling our bodies in this position. And then taking that opposite hand to ground down to help lift yourself up. Maybe keeping those eyes closed. Let's come into a seated position. Reconnecting those sit bones with Mother Earth as we sit up nice and tall. Let's seal our practice together as we take a nice deep inhale, lifting those arms up overhead, palms touch. And let's bring that energy, that light, that love, that healing down into the heart space. As we bow with gratitude and love for ourselves, for others, and for our practice. Namaste. Thank you, everyone, for joining me. Namaste.